Okay, now we're going to use two variables for to predict whether a person is going to survive or die from hornet stings. All right, so the number of stings and the age. So here is the plot of our data. Right, so the predicted probability of death is now our logistic function. So this is sigmoid of, well, of beta 0 plus beta 1 x1 plus beta 2 x2. And so we have one more value. Now I have fitted this logistic regression in R, and this is what I've got. Right? So these are the values of the coefficients. So there is the beta 0 is my intercept, beta 1 is the coefficient at the number of stings, and beta 2 is the coefficient at age. Now, for 50 stings, the expected probability to die now depends on the age, right? So at the age of 50 is much less than the expected probability to die at the age of 80, of course. Very reasonable. Right, so I'm printing it, so just to make sure that it makes sense. Well, and the minimum loss function is going to be, of course, it's going to be smaller, right? Than the minimum loss function for one variable, right? So because hypothetically, you know, if we had the value of beta zero and beta one that minimizes the loss function when there is just one predictor, then by just letting the third variable to be zero, we can guarantee the same loss for two predictors, right? And by modifying it somehow, we will of course decrease the loss function, right? So the loss function with more predictors is always going to be smaller than the loss function with fewer predictors. Okay, so here is the decision boundary, and notice a funny thing, right? So notice that now three observations are misclassified, right? So this misclassified, this is misclassified, and this is misclassified. So three observations are misclassified. However, if you change the parameters of the logistic regression, so it is possible to change it so that it becomes more accurate, right? So even though, so if you change the decision boundary to this one, you will see that now the first two observations are going to be classified correctly, right? So this observation is still misclassified, and this observation is going to be misclassified, right? So, but now only two observations are misclassified, right? So originally, the misclassification rate was 3 over 16, and it is possible to change the decision boundary so that the misclassification rate is 2 over 16. Right? So what I want to say is that even though what you see on the picture is the combination of parameter values that minimizes the loss function, it does not mean that it minimizes the error rate. Right? So the error rate could be even smaller. But the reason this hypothetical logistic regression that minimizes the error rate is not really the one that minimizes the loss function is because now it mispredicts this observation by a large margin, right? So that there is a large distance, so which means that we kind of predict that this is survival with a high confidence, while this is actually death. All right, so here only two observations are misclassified, but they are misclassified by a large margin, while the loss function that the combination of betas that actually minimizes the loss function is that it misclassifies three observations rather than two, but out of three, only one is misclassified with a large margin. So, and two are misclassified, just they are nearly missed, so the probability is just slightly different from one. Okay, well, this is confusion matrix for the one variable logistic regression. So there are three observations I misclassified. All right, so for the two variable logistic regression, even though the loss is smaller, still two observations I misclassified, but not the same two. So if you compare the two logistic regressions, one with one predictor and the other one with two predictors, then they're different, right? So they're not perfectly consistent. So which means that neither of them is more accurate than the other one, but they are not really the same. Okay, so now please do the quiz.